this church at Teretti Bazar is under Chungyi Thong. Chungyi Thong, I'll tell you something. Chungyi Thong is a very old club set up by Hakka in Calcutta. The Chinese are mainly Cantonese, Hupai. Shanghai was there, okay? Now Shanghai are just few families in Calcutta. And now mainly you will find a lot of Hupaks which are in dentistry. Then the Cantonese like Sei Wei and Nanking, you know, they are into, they are there, and then we are the Hakkas. So this club was one of the, maybe one of the oldest, almost 200 years. That property in 17 Teretti Bazar is set up in 1831 and completed in 1834. But I have just joined this committee in the last 8 years now. That temple is dedicated to the god of voyage, I think. I'm not very sure. There are so many gods and goddesses. Coming back to taking this church forward, it's inherited. We just hope to maintain and hopefully pass on the legacy of this church, the temples that is there, and carry forward. Nothing very. We're not going to. I have no intention of going propagating about our temple. But religion and belief is something very private. Okay, if you wish to come and pray, we welcome you. But I will not go and propagate. You know, it's something I'm very sensitive about. I wouldn't like anybody telling me believe in this. Well, shoe trade, I would say, see, all along Chinese were in shoe trade and leather business. Shoe trade is on the wane, on the downslide, I would say. For the simple reason is our children don't want to take up the business anymore. Food business is going up. There are a lot of Chinese restaurants sprouting all over. And restaurant is one business the children seems to be taking it up happier because, you know, you can innovate and for some reasons, they like to take over restaurants. But shoe business, family style, it's not happening anymore. They don't want it. My daughters are not here. Okay. A lot of my friends, colleagues, their children also are not wanting to take this business up. They've gone into IT, they've gone into restaurants, and every other thing except their traditional business. We just live by the day, whatever existing properties that are there, the burial ground, we try to clean up the burial ground. What I really hope to take up, I don't have that means or the resources yet, but we have a big problem in our burial ground. It's an open, huge plot of land, and our cemetery, if you ever get a chance to go there, it is not like other Western cemetery where they're all very flat places. Each of us, when we have our unfortunate incident of our family members passing away, so we bury them, and we have two kinds of burial. One is we bury them with the full, like with the coffin, and we don't take them up forever, like my mother. Okay, so in that the burial place is very longish.
Okay.
And in front we keep the names and placard, whatever. So these structures can be very big and bulky some, and because we also follow Vastu, Feng Shui, okay, you all call it Vastu. So the directions are different for different years and at the time of death, okay. So at that time of death, the direction has to face say northwest or southeast or whatever the direction is. So that our tombs are all haphazard and wasn't very planned. So the gaps are not very good. Not accessible for a lot of people. The grass, the trees are growing very wildly, easily because it's open air, huge plots, birds come and do droppings, and you know, plants just grow. So I am trying to, I'm hoping that, you know, we can keep our burial ground nice and clean of grass and extra weeds. I'm only hoping that if I can get some help, hopefully from the municipality, you know, to get this garden department or whatever, and the drainage. Our property is over 130, 150 years old, that burial ground. And the land levels compared to the streets have also, in comparison has gone down. Mm. So even that little water logging is happening. Mm. So in, because of water logging, then we have create that little place for mosquito breeding, you know. So it's something that we don't want, but we don't know how to go about that. So if I can get help to get this problem sorted out, the water stagnation. We've just been to the conservancy department. One end of the drain was clogged for some time. Mm. So the water wasn't going freely. Mm. And also the land level has also gone lower than before. So this one, plus if I can get the grass all pruned nicely, you know, then I would really feel nice. It's one project that I really want to give to our forefathers, people who are resting in that burial ground, to have a nice clear place. Mm. So whoever wants to go and remember and honor them, they can go and pray there. See, India has been very generous, especially this locality of mine, Calcutta. Mm. I am more Calcutta than I feel I am Chinese. Only thing is, when I come and mix out with my friend, then we have our own eating habits, the language come into the picture. But otherwise, when we are doing adda and all, it's all bindas. You know, I think it's one of the very comfortable place. So when you feel comfortable, you don't feel like leaving. So I think Indians are very generous in that way and very acceptable, accommodating, especially Bengalis. Especially Bengalis. Let's hope that festivity comes back, because Puja is one beautiful, unique festival that you don't see in any other places. In other places, our Chinese New Year, when you go to China, it is very quiet. Christmas is the same thing in England and in Canada or New York, whatever that is. It's Puja, Durga Puja is like, Calcutta is so beautiful. In those 10 days, 2 weeks, now Didi has increased that to, you know, after post Dasami, they have that, you know, that red road parade. Yeah. So it made it, extended the festivity. So we only hope that COVID go away and let's come back with all that Puja celebrations and the beautiful city that we get to have for that 2 weeks now.
খবরের আপডেট পেতে সাবস্ক্রাইব করুন আমাদের ইউটিউব চ্যানেলটি আর বেল আইকনে ক্লিক করুন নোটিফিকেশনস পেতে।